This video will show you how to use Octoparse to capture web content. Before we start, I want to stress again that most websites have policies regulating or limiting web crawling or scraping, and it's completely forbidden on some websites. You can often find these policies in the website's terms of service. Make sure you check those regulations before using Octoparse or any other tool to crawl a website. Another document that provides useful information for web scraping is robots.txt, which is a text document containing restrictions on how robots or programs built to access web content can interact with its pages. You can access this document by just adding robots.txt to the URL, such as this. For Amazon.com, you see a long list of disallow and some allows. So these are the areas where the robots can or cannot visit. For this exercise, we will first use a test website built by Octoparse where you can practice crawling without worrying about infringing any website's policy. You can find the link to this test website below the YouTube video. It imitates three types of popular websites: e-commerce, showing online shopping page, a news portal, and a web page containing a table. Of course, all the information on these web pages are meaningless, but they have similar patterns as some real websites we might be interested in, so we can practice all the same. Now let's open Octoparse and log in with the username and password that you created. If it's the first time you're opening the app, you might see a tour. Feel free to explore it or skip it. The home page contains links to popular tutorials and two ways of creating a new task. Task templates provide template for popular websites like Amazon, Twitter, Google. Advanced mode lets you build your own crawler. So for any websites without a template or you want to do something other than what the template is built for, you have to use the advanced mode. Here, you need to put the URL of the website that you want to crawl, and it also allows importing a file or batch processing. I'm going to copy this URL for e-commerce page. Okay, this seems a little complicated, but don't worry about it for now. You can toggle this workflow off to hide this top panel for now. The bottom panel is currently a selector where you can just click on any elements on the page to select it. Like, I'm going to click on the first product name, and you see there is an action tips window showing me some possible actions I could take. It found 8 similar elements on the page, which are the 8 product names. I would like to extract those and maybe also the prices into a dataset with 2 columns. So I'm going to select all. That selects all 8 items containing the product names, and then I click extract text of the selected elements. Now, if you turn on workflow again, you see a loop item is created, and it extracts data, creating this field 1 containing the product names. We can change the field name here, choosing name, or you can type in something different. Now, can you tell how to extract prices as well? Click on the first price. I can either select all or I can just go ahead and click second price. And you see all 8 prices automatically selected because when I click on 2 first elements of a list, Octoparse will often be able to tell what the rest of the list looks like, so it selects all of them. And I can do the same, extract text. Right now I have 2 fields. At the bottom of this panel, you can reorder the fields. Deselect them. You can reorder it. You can delete the field. You can add predefined fields such as current time or information about current page URL. Now I'm gonna start extraction and select local extraction. And we get our 8 lines of data, 8 products, 2 columns. Alright, you can export data here into one of these formats, but I'm not done yet, so I'm closing it for now. Sometimes we need more information than just the product names and prices, and some of those information is only available on the product details page, so we need to ask the web crawler to click into each of these links and get information from the individual products page. So let's see how to do that. Again, I select the first 2 elements of a list and all 8 products are selected. And now I choose loop click each element. Okay, so the first product page is open and here are some other information. So I'm gonna select the elements that I want to extract. Okay, title, the price, short description, a category, and you can also choose the detailed description and maybe reviews if there are any related products. But I think I'm done. I'm gonna extract data. Okay, you see it's created into a new step loop item in the workflow, and here you can drag and rearrange these workflows, and we don't need to extract data here anymore. If you didn't export the previous data, it will ask you if you want to load it again. I don't really need it, so I'm just gonna overwrite. Okay, you can see for the same 8 products, we get more information here by clicking into each of the product pages. Yes. Alright, but there are more than 8 products. Go back. I use this to switch the browser mode. I'll visit this again. There are more than 8 products because there are more pages, right? There are only 8 products on each page. Sometimes we want to get more than what's present on the first page. So we also need the web crawler to click each of these following pages or just loop click the next page button. And this is called pagination. It's a very common thing in web crawling. So see how to do that. First I want to select that and go back to the selector mode. Select the next page button and loop click the selected link. Now you see a pagination step is added to the workflow, and that includes the previous loop item that we created to get information from each individual product page. So on each following page, it will do the same. It will click into each individual products page and get those information for us. But make sure that this loop item, you see these are different nodes on the workflow. Make sure that this is before click to paginate and it's within the whole pagination block. So you do the loop item before clicking next page. So you do this for products on the first page first, and then you click next and do it for page 2 and click next and do it for page 3. Now we no longer need to set the field names. I already set the field names, but sometimes it's a good practice to set a wait before execution time for every loop click, because many websites have the policy, and sometimes in their robots.txt that they expect your robots to wait a little bit between two clicks, because if you just click nonstop, it's not polite, right? It could overwhelm the website. So let's set it to 1 second between every two clicks, and that makes it more like a human being. Similarly for pagination. So sometimes we don't want to extract all the pages information. There could be many, many pages, and sometimes we're only interested in the first few pages. And that's why you can set this end loop when execution times reach, say, 5. So we don't need all those pages. All right, let's start extraction, see what we get. Alright, now we have the data from the first few pages extracted.